And one of the most common things I hear at town meetings, the issue of uncertainty in our economy, and the issue that regulations are forcing businesses to make decisions not to hire new people, but to actually either stay and prevent from growing, or to actually reduce in size. And so with that, I would yield to the gentleman from Illinois.
I thank the gentleman for yielding. I still am just thinking about the regulations from this week, and the week's not over. We still got another day of regulations that are going to be coming out. And we hear time and again from our colleagues on the other side of the aisle that it's been 10 months and still no jobs bill. We hear it time and again when the one-minute speeches and we open up session, the other side say still no jobs bill. Well, I beg to differ. We've got jobs bills. We talk about the forgotten 15. We've got several more. We passed some tonight. Part of our plan is to empower the private sector. Part of our plan is to make sure that we're eliminating some of the uncertainty that's out there. And let me just tell you, the week of regulations, just 1 week of regulations that are out here that literally shakes the desk when you drop it, is certainly not creating more certainty. Now, the one thing that I am pleased to say is that I believe that we were sent here to be able to work with those on the other side of the aisle to move our country forward. I am pleased to say that we passed bills today talking about access to capital for job creators, like many of us here have come in from the private sector, broad bipartisan support. The President of the United States came and spoke before the chamber here in a joint session talking about a jobs plan. As opposed to saying, no, I don't want it, what I intend and tried to talk to others about, and I know many agree, is what are the areas that we agree on? Talk about free trade or the trade agreements. We agree. We pass those. It's going to talk about 250,000 American jobs, increasing our bottom line in terms of our GDP by $10 billion this year alone, with South Korea as the only one. We add Colombia and Panama, and that number obviously rises. The President talks about the burdensome regulations. We agree. We need to make sure we have regulations, as the gentlelady from Washington noted. We want them to be smart regulations. Not just more of them. I mean, my goodness, how much does it cost us to even print these? Long and the short of it is that we need to create an environment. We need to create an environment for the private sector out there with broad bipartisan support. And I believe that if we ask those on the other side of the aisle, what's the biggest issue facing our country today? It's jobs and the economy. We just have a different view of who should be creating those jobs. I believe it should be the private sector. I believe the private sector, entrepreneurship, the United States of America has been and continues to be the greatest force for hope the world has ever known. We have 29 million small businesses in our nation. If we can create an environment where half of them can create a single job, think about where we'd be then. Let's just take a look at this, because these are some bold points. And I think, you know, if I ask the gentleman from Illinois to talk to me about empowering small businesses and reducing government barriers to job creation, I guarantee you he can give me a couple things that we're doing right now here in this Congress. If I talk to the gentleman from Colorado about fixing the tax code to help job creators, I know that he'd come up with some things, because we've already done it. We passed a budget. We're at 918 days in the United States Senate. 918 days and still no budget. Yet the law requires the Congress to come up with a budget every April 15th. And yet that responsibility, by the way, it's against the law, has been shirked by the United States Senate. We're going to hear more about this do-nothing Congress, and I want to make sure that the American public knows that we are here passing what we believe is common-sense legislation in a bipartisan fashion to move the country forward. We realize that unless things pass the United States Senate and go to the President's desk for signature, we're not going to be able to move the needle. The American public is frustrated. We're frustrated, too, because I believe that the American dream is at stake. The American compact that we all came to Congress to deal with, that we leave the country better for the next generation than we received from our parents and grandparents, I believe is in jeopardy today. That to me is completely unacceptable.
Will the gentleman yield?
Absolutely.
I'd just like to say, I had asked for the totals, I didn't have them written down, but you take the kind of bipartisan support that you're talking about that we received on the two bills that we passed just today, the access to capital and the access for entrepreneurs. You take that kind of bipartisan support. The American people are frustrated because the president is calling this the Republican Congress. This is a bicameral Congress, and whereas we hold the majority in this House, we don't in the Senate. But you saw the actions that took place on the floor tonight. The first one passed 407-17. The second bill passed 413-11. There is a way to find common ground without compromising principle. And that is what we are doing, because the American people are hurting, and we've got to create that environment, and we have, by passing these bills. And we are calling on those in the Senate to see our bipartisanship in this House to get Americans back to work.
And I thank the gentlewoman for commenting on that. There's no doubt. Look, bipartisanship can be done. The American public is frustrated because they don't think that we're working, and in some instances, you know, we know that Washington can be broken. We want to work together because we know we've got to move the ball down the field. We know we've got to get people back to work. We've got a 9.1% unemployment. What's it in Wisconsin?
About 9%.
About 9%. In Illinois, it's at 10%. In certain areas of the 10th District, in Illinois, we've got areas of 20 to 22%. I can tell you that jobs right now, absolutely number one priority. And that's why I'm willing to work with anybody here in Washington that's willing to listen, that's willing to reach across the aisle to come up with solutions. And I want to let you know, if people are saying that we don't have a plan, we've got a plan. Jobs.gop.gov. I welcome everybody to be able to go get it, and I'll yield back.
Well, and I want to thank the gentleman from Illinois for his comments, because when he started talking tonight, he talked about his great hope and optimism for this country, the fact that we really do live in the greatest nation on the face of this earth.